pretending to sleep.
Okay, I think you're supposed to get up. We've got that sort of weird wolf-looking guy in the darkness gave us some sort of token.
I thought you meant this guy, the moon.
No, not his dad or whatever it is.
Yeah, so we've got an item, but yeah.
Weird. No missions. I can do whatever.
Why do you look so happy?
It's being told to go back to bed.
Okay, let's have a look at this item. What is it? Is it some sort of key?
It looks like a key.
It looks like a weird little screwdriver.
Okay, it looks
or a
like
screwdriver.
A weird little screwdriver.
Nothing like a screwdriver.
No. Okay, can we get any stuff from our room? I wouldn't wake him up.
What's that?
It's a tank of compressed air.
What?
Could be useful in an emergency.
Yeah.
Yeah, right. Like, we have those.
Fake emergencies.
Missions cancelled until further notice. Whoops. She says it's a humidifier, but I think it's some sort of mind control device. Either way, it's dead now. I took away its food source.
The compressed
air, I guess. Yeah.
Okay,
what's this?
Hmm.
It's very
dead. Given a screwed shut with
not
these weird little screws.
Yet. Nah, we'll have a
look. Because I want to look at these doors.
I'm sure there's some more stuff we can do. Oh.
It's locked. What a dirty trick.
Hey, what are you doing out of bed, Buster?
What am I? Your prisoner?
Just until I'm sure you're safe. You have no idea how important you are, Shay.
What is important?
Try and get up again?
Big snore.
Okay, that's
okay.
Health stats 100% normal, as always. Maybe I'm the robot. Why do computers need sleep?
Okay, we should probably go unscrew that.
Is there anything else? It
doesn't look like it.
It's a tank of compressed air. Could be useful in an emergency. Yeah, right. Like we have those. It works!
I like the way you just threw it away.
So this is pretty simple so far.
Yeah.
But I guess it normally is in the beginning. It's about...
What's this?
Learn how the game
It looks like an inflatable raft.
What?
It looks like an inflatable raft.
It looks like an inflatable raft.
In case we use the compressed air on the inflatable raft.
Maybe this air tank has enough pressure to blow up this raft. Whoa! Looks like a blow-up doll of me. Creepy.
This is creepy. Okay. What? Oh, put that in the bed.
Oh, good one.
I'm going to call him Little Lazy Me.
Do you think you can jump down that ventilation shaft?
Well, that's what I thought it was.
Hopefully.
For, but
this looks
maybe
enough
not.
Like me to fool the warden.
Really?
Hey, how am I on the bed and over here at the same... Oh, yeah. That's just a blow-up doll. Woo!
Well, hopefully the computer isn't that observant. Maybe it's
still
there. I want to get there.
Where's my little angel? Oh, there he is. Oh, to think I almost lost you today. Sleep tight, little hero.
Everything about this is really
Man,
creepy so
computers
far.
Are stupid. Yeah.
Who is that?
Big bad wolf.
Whoa. How have I never seen this part of the ship before?
You came because you are done with children's games.
Yes. Who are you?
My name is Marek, and what I'm about to show you is no game. While you've been drifting through the universe, eating ice cream, playing with trains, war has been raging across the galaxy.
War? Between who?
Between the forces that every war is between. Between the powerful and the weak, the tyrants and the innocent.
But who?
Does it even matter? There will always be war. We did not start it, and we cannot stop it. What we can do is protect the weak and rescue the helpless. Look at this distress signal I just received from a peaceful colony in the Talon Nebula. The helpless creatures you see have been imprisoned by forces of tyranny and may soon be executed.
But...
Yes?
We have to save them.
Yes. Yes, we do. I'm pleased you feel as such.
We have to go tell the ship's computer.
No. You must tell no one on this ship what I have just told you. This ship is programmed with one function, to keep you safe.
Yeah, I noticed that.
To help these creatures, you will need to put yourself at risk in a way she could never understand.
No, you're right. She would never understand. So what can we do?
First, we have to get to the Talon Nebula. Take this star chart to the navigation room. I have an earpiece for you to wear, so we can stay in contact. Use that vent to avoid detection. Return immediately after you're successful.
But...
Quickly, young cub, we don't have much time.
I like him, he's cool. What's his name, Marek?
It's kind of weird, Aaron, those like close-ups in that cinematic. They looked really pixely.
I guess it's just like in game.
This is the star chart for Talon Nebula.
Why is it drawing me crayons?
Excuse me, Marek?
What are you doing? There's no time to waste. Take that vent to the navigation room and give that star chart to the Space Weaver right now.
Use the Space Weaver.
I don't want to click on things.
Those poor creatures.
They're counting on you, young Cobb.
What's this here? Nothing.
He's got security cameras everywhere.
Only for your protection.
Oh, this is like even creepier than this.
Yeah.
Time to save some helpless creatures.
Do not touch those until I tell you that it's time.
Oh. What if he's
I apologize. It's just that I build them myself and I'm a little protective.
Okay, so that's...
Oops, I guess that was going back to the hole.
Right, so that's... What's that one?
The store is locked.
This is a stealth mission. Not safe to use the hallways, understand?
Oh, you should click on that. I know you can do.
Ah, the young master has come to play with the Space Weaver. Where shall we go today, wise commander?
Oh man, a real mission for once. This is so fun.
This is serious, Shay. Stay focused.
You can hear everything I say?
Yes. Please don't say anything embarrassing.
Do you want to talk to the Space Weaver a bit first?
Okay.
Hey, Space Weaver. Let's go somewhere exciting for a change.
I have been programmed to take the young master wherever he desires, as long as it is safe and free of conflict.
Aww.
Bring me a star chart, and the fabric of time and space shall be knit to serve your passage.
You have a star chart?
Yes.
Shall I give it to him?
Can you go down that ladder? Oh, that's really pretty.
Oh, he's weaving.
Yeah.
Something.
If I give the Space Weaver a star chart, he'll weave the destination pattern into this nav scarf.
I wish all spaceships were able to. Sorry, weaving.
Hey, Space Weaver, can you take me here?
With pleasure.
How does he know if it's safe or not?
Preparing decryption mechanism. Initializing warp and wolf drive.
What's a warp drive?
Intake calipers in position. Weave thrusters at viscosity. Spindle at rotational velocity. Deploying nav scarf in 5, 4, 3.
I hope he doesn't get into trouble.
Two,
through the space reader.
Yeah.
No,
yeah,
when he runs out.
Just doing my job.
So I guess we can go back to Merrick.
It does look like a talon.
Oh, yeah. Do you see it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I guess go back.
Better not go out there while the ship's in high alert mode.
Yeah, he does seem a bit creepy, doesn't he?
We should be in the Talon Nebula now.
Great work, young cub. We're approaching the location of the distress signal now.
Do you think he's got ulterior motive?
This is worse than I thought. The good news is their captors have left them unguarded for the time being.
What can I do?
Here, take these controls. You need to lower the shields so the boom arms can be extended. Go on, lower the shields.
Seems like Big Bad Wolf and all that, like in Little Red Riding Hood, is always the bad guy. So it's a thing like completely the opposite.
Yeah, that's why I don't trust him.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Good. Now wait until the boom arm is correctly positioned above the subject, then press this to engage.
I got it!
Great work, Shay. Now the boom arms will haul it in and place it in the auxiliary cargo hold.
I should go see if it's okay. No.
They must remain in complete quarantine for their own protection. And ours.
You mean our diseases might kill them?
You are wise for such a young cub. Now we must save more quickly before their captors return. Use the movement controls to position the ship. Position the ship so the cargo booms can grab one of the creatures. Careful.
Got another one.
Great. Now just place it in the cargo hold and... Oh no.
What is it?
Hostile forces have been detected nearby. They're coming in our direction. We need to retreat.
Not yet. There's still one more to save.
No time. We have to pull out immediately or we'll be destroyed.
You don't want to save
no!
It.
No!
No!
You didn't tell me I'd have to pick who lived and died.
You want to be a grown-up? Get used to making tough decisions. No time to mourn. There's another distress signal.
That's really sad.
This one's from Danger System 5. Are you up to it? Shay. Are you the master of your feelings, or are they the master of you?
Give me the star chart.
Is that a frog in your throat?
It's all that came up on the air. You can still see the one that you let down.
I don't want to see that. It's just depressing.
Hey, Space Weaver, can you take me here?
Good idea! Preparing decryption mechanism. Initializing warp and wolf drive.
Wolf drive.
Intake calipers in position. Weave thrusters at viscosity.
Okay, we should be in Danger System 5.
Are we ever? Take a look at this.
Make me choose again.
Take that shield.
Careful. Excellent. Securing subject and cargo hold.
Wait for it.
Oh shit.
Oh, no.
Oh, am I too high? Oh shit, what am I doing?
Just see the creature in your mind's eye, then simply release.
Thanks.
Don't wait forever, though. Great work!
Don't you dare say, oh no!
Good.
It's like a Christmas pudding.
But hurry, we're running out of time.
What?
Oh, oh,
what
the
fuck?
Go on, move the ship.
Ah! Hey,
that's okay.
Oh,
okay,
no.
That's enough.
What do you mean that's enough?
I mean, enemy ships
see,
are.
See, I
approaching.
Don't trust this
I don't
guy.
See anything. I need to save this last one.
You're going to endanger the whole mission to
yes.
save one creature?
Yes, please.
Yeah, can you give me the option?
Just give me a second.
I don't think we're saving them.
Right. It's just a little
this
arcade
is a waste
game. It's
of
not
time.
Really.
No, I think.
There
I
is
think
no.
Well, why would you say stop?
Okay, I got it.
But something's wrong.
Cut it loose. We need to retreat before.
It's a virus.
Attention, ship is under attack.
What happened?
Probably one of the enemy vessels I warned you about, remember?
We need to get that last creature.
Too late. The ship is retreating under autopilot to a safe location. And we're completely locked out of the controls.
How are we going to perform any more rescues?
We'll have to find another way to hack into the boom arm controls. And another way to bring the shields down at the right time. And who knows if we'll be able to navigate to the right system now that the ship's on high alert.
The ship's computer must be freaking out right now.
Oh, yes. As soon as the alarm sounded, the first thing she probably did was check on you and your...
Oh, no.
Shay! Shay! Are you hurt? Oh, thank goodness. Don't worry, sweetie. Something attacked the ship, but Mommy's taking care of it.
What's he doing?
Nothing to worry about, okay?
Everything's so bad.
Oh, so brave.
Whew. Better get back to Merrick to hear his plan.
The thing flew off in the touch.
Did I drop something? I think it's gone.
Well, we've still got more compressed air.
Yeah, we don't have that anymore.
Wait, young cub. It is not time to deploy the
yes,
rescue system yet.
Something very creepy. Voice, isn't
Christmas
it?
Pudding!
Oh, no.
Frog squid. Octopus and toast.
Oh, octopus and toast crying.
Any luck with the ship's controls?
Why are they sad?
No, but
them.
We intercepted a new distress signal, this time from Prima Doom.
Okay. I'm gonna ask him personal questions.
Yeah. Straight to
so,
the
how long have you been living in here?
I am a recent stowaway. I came because I sensed you were ready.
Are you really a wolf?
Are you really a wolf?
No, I wear this disguise to blend in with your other stuffed animal friends.
Weird. So that's a wolf suit? What are you underneath?
I am what I do. A rescuer of creatures in need, just like you.
Why do I have to be the one to choose who to rescue?
A boy your age just has good instincts for the job.
Well, he's so up to something else, isn't
he? Yeah. Okay, let's ask him how.
How are we going to get control of the ship's cargo boom arms?
We'll need to attempt a manual override. The manual boom arm controls are located here. You can get to them through the ship's airlock here. I've hacked the airlock door so you can now open it without alerting the Overmother.
How are we going to take down the shields?
I have a plan. The shields require so much power, they have a dedicated source. This fusion orb. Take this Omicron inhibitor and place it over the fusion orb. And when the time is right, we'll turn it on and turn off the fusion orb.
Along with the ship's shields. Got it. The distress call was from Prima Doom? How do we get there?
Same as always. Take this star chart to the Space Weaver and hope for the best.
Right. I'd better get back to the mission.
Yes. Our window of opportunity won't last forever.
So do you reckon it's the door to that door?
Yeah,
it's the only other door,
yeah.
I think.
The helpless creatures we rescued are being quarantined in there. Wish I could let them out. But it's for their own safety, I guess. Judging by the wolf hair, this must be where Merrick sleeps.
Yeah.
What was that? Ew.
Yeah. Filthy wolf hair
everywhere. Nice! Stitching up there!
Oh, so cute. Can we just pick him up and pick him?
Oh. He's looking this way.
Yeah.
Can you talk? Can we continue stitching? No, I have fun.
Can we just stay in this room?
Yeah.
Look at him all day.
That should be for acting. Acting like I cared about the stupid missions on this ship. Hey, the helmet comes off. Ah, my first hazard suit. Kept out Omicron radiation and kept in diaper leaks. Ah, my first hazard suit. Man, how tiny was I when I used to wear this radiation helmet? I think that's supposed to be a space urchin, or else that's my old gum pile that I used to keep under my bed. I think that's the ratty old washcloth I used to drag around the spaceship. I really hope she washed that thing. As soon as we get full control
of
this ship, I'm going to burn this stuff.
It's terrifying.
She bronzed my first space shoes. Or is that the remains of my old bomb squad bot?
I said that like BMO's face.
I made a hexipal out of a paper plate. Probably thought they were alive then. I wonder what's in those creepy jars. My old teeth?
Yeah.
Hair? I never want to see another train as long as I live. I gave up making art years ago. If
really
no one's around to see it,
stalker.
Who cares?
Yeah.
Teleporter, activate.
May I teleport you to the Nexus? No malfunction.
That's terrifying.
Hey, my head.
What's wrong?
My head is smaller.
Is it?
Yeah, you just used a teleporter.
Why did my head shrink?
Is it small?
Quantum physics.
Don't worry,
it'll all go back to normal when you take the trip back through me. Big baby.
That doesn't look... I can't remember how big it was.
Man, how tiny was I when I used to wear this radiation helmet?
I guess we don't need it now. Just skip the other doors. Whoops.
Oh.
Son, I'm not sure it's safe enough for you to leave your room.
Tired of being a prisoner in my room. I'm sick of being a prisoner on this ship.
I know, son. I know it's hard. You've given up so much. Listen. I'd like to tell you a story. A story of another person your age, a young girl. She wanted to live a normal life, but she was chosen. She was honored with a special duty. Some people would call it a sacrifice, but what she didn't realize at the time was that it was a great honor.
Please, I've heard the story of the sacrifice girl a million times. I know the ending. The sacrifice girl is you, right?
What I'm trying to tell you is that I made a hard choice, but I regret nothing because...
Great story, computer. I'm sorry they programmed you with someone's sad memories, but I have to go.
You know the truth deep down, son. And I know you'll appreciate my words someday.
Uh-huh. Brother.